Welcome back everyone, Meme Pooh here, and today I'm going to try Roblox on this machine. It's equipped with a 2070 Super and an i7-10875H. In some games, the GPU was utilized more than usual, and in others, it was vice versa. The same goes for the CPU. Power and thermals were set to balanced, and no overclocking was used. A few games that I played, I dropped the graphics to a minimum for just a few seconds to see what it was going to be, and changed it back to max quality. I'll show this on the screen, and you'll know what I'm doing when it happens. The first game we have is Work at a Pizza Place. In this game, you can become a cashier, you can become a delivery driver, and there's other jobs that you can do. You can actually get paid in the game to use for some in-game items. The first thing I'm going to do is become a cashier and take some orders from one of the patrons coming in. When they first come in, you'll ask if you can take the order, and then they'll have like a little scripted line, and then you go ahead and try to answer what they want. Maybe they want a pepperoni pizza, cheese pizza, maybe they want a, you know, a sausage pizza. And you can pick from the left side over there if you want to do a response. But once you get the correct answer, the order goes to the back in preparation for the chef. Here I decided to go to the back to see what was going on, and it was pizzas everywhere. I decided to put some of the pizzas in the oven to get them cooked. So we're taking them out of the oven. I'm going to go ahead and put them on the conveyor so they can be packaged. There's also like an order at the top of the screen that shows you what type of pizza needs to be made. So here's the packaging area. You want to go ahead and take a pizza and put it inside of the box. Take a pizza box down. I kind of like messed that one up. And go ahead and put the pizza in and slide it through the wall. There's also soft drinks that you can put in the wall as well. And this will head over to the delivery guys that's waiting to deliver the item. There's a lot of people that drop in and out back here. So once you get your item, go ahead and get in a car. I guess you could walk. I think there's a little motorcycle too, but get in your car and head down the road as fast as you can so you can go ahead and deliver the item. When you arrive at your destination, just go right up to the door and they will answer and you will get some money. Go ahead and leave and go back to the destination of the pizza place and start all over. You can actually do a different job. I think you can become a manager as well. Pretty good game. This is Robot 64. It's like a generic Mario 64. If you remember that one, it was on the Nintendo 64. So what you do is you collect a bunch of ice cream cones, and this will allow you to get through certain portals. Like, I collected one and it allows me to go through here. There's also some, I guess you could buy some things from these little areas here. I didn't try, but I'm just assuming that you could. But anyway, we're going to jump through this one portal just like in Mario 64. And the level starts out like Mario 64. It pans from you, shows you what the area looks like, and then it goes back to your view. You have different moves. You got a spin move. You can actually flop on your belly and do like a little slide. You have a skateboard that you can use, but I didn't use it in this playthrough. There's also different portals that are hidden on the map. Here I'm just trying to platform up to the top to get in to see what's in there. I arrived and it looks like a bunch of flower petals that you have to jump on, and they spin at the same time. So be careful because you can fall off. Here's another neat little board. It's on the back of a turtle. And again, I'm collecting some candy. Looks like a bunch of bunny rabbits down there, like a little bunny town. I actually talked to this rabbit right here, and it reminded me of the Mario 64 and asked me if I wanted to race him to the top. What I did find out though is you don't have to follow him. all the way, you can just go straight to the top of the mountain and you'll beat him. But I was actually trying to follow him the exact direction he was going, and he was going all over the map, but he finally made it to where he was supposed to go, and I was behind and I lost. It's a pretty decent game. Here I was just jumping on, just trying some different moves. You can't actually kill, but you can flatten them. Here is Natural Disaster Survival. I like this game. It's an older game. The object of the game is to survive natural disasters. There's like volcanic disasters, acid rain disasters, lightning storm disasters, floods, and things like that. The best thing to do is try to get somewhere where you will not be affected. Most of the time you'll find a lot of people under stairs. Unless there's like wind, the wind disaster is really brutal. And the one that like freezes, I believe it's like a blizzard disaster. That gets a lot of people too. Pretty easy. And you know, just looking on the screen, this acid rain, this disaster is not bad. You can look up and see where the rain is going to be or what's going to fall. Just look at the colors, they'll change. And then once they turn green, they'll fall to the bottom. Just make sure you're not under it when it falls, because it can damage you, and if you get hit too many times, you'll die. A lot of people crowd under stairs. And what's neat about it, you get to see all the different costumes. I haven't bought any costumes for my character, as I'm still stock. This one is Murder Mystery 2. Starting out, right now, I'm in the lobby, and I'm waiting actually for my turn. Here, you can vote on a map when it becomes available. Starting out here in this area, you are picked to become an innocent person, or I think the murderer, and you kind of like take out the people, hopefully where no one can see, but you can definitely hear when someone gets shot. You can hear it. It's just like gunshots. So I'm just running around. I mean, I can hear the gunshots, but I don't know who's doing it. It might be that guy right there with the wings, because I think I saw something come out of the front of him. Looked like he had a gun. So I was just trying to avoid the guy. I was just walking, running around the map. I ended up going to the top where this ventilation is, and I just stayed up here for the duration of the map. And I survived. This game right here is Jailbreak, and what you do here is you're a prisoner and you have to break out of the jail, and then you escape into the city and do more crime. You can actually team up with other people, but you know, the cops are out there, and if they catch you, then you go back, you break out again and do the same thing. Here on my first try of trying to break out of the prison, I ended up still inside of the police compound. I thought I was going to take this car and try to get out. Couldn't get out. The gate wouldn't open, so I tried to jump, and that didn't work either. There's a cop trying to get me. And, of course, yeah, he got me, and he put me back in the cell. So I'm going to try and get out again. Got the gate open, got in the car, so we're just driving through the city, we're just looking around. Can't cause any havoc, I don't have any guns. You know, I don't even think you can get guns in this game. You might, I'm not sure. But here's a bank. I went in to see what was going on. I didn't see anywhere to go. It looked like everything was blocked. So I'm going to head back outside and see if I can get in the truck. But when I decided to do that, I saw where you can get in. But, you know, I was caught. I didn't see that cop. This is Ghost Simulator, and you can pick low quality or high quality, and of course I picked high quality. This game is like Ghostbusters. And starting out, you talk to this guy here, and he has you doing a couple of errands. And each time you complete an errand, he gives you some coins and some advice on what to do next. And once you get enough, you get to upgrade your equipment, like your backpack and the amount of ghosts you can keep. When I played the game, I don't know if the ghosts can hurt you, but I do know that when you are trying to catch the ghosts, that you can team up with another partner or some random in the game and catch ghosts at the same time, and it makes it quicker. Upgrading your vacuum will make catching the ghosts quicker, and upgrading your backpack will let you keep more ghosts before you go back to sell them. Again, once you complete the objective, you go back to this guy here and he gives you another one to complete. Right now we're going to go ahead and try to beat this boss. You can fast travel there or you can run. So we're all here and we're going to try to take down this green guy. He looks like a cactus. This boss can't move, although he does have a few moves at his disposal, such as a poison cloud and some heat-seeking missiles. They'll follow you for a while and then they'll kind of like die off if you outrun it. He also has like a ground stomp that'll move you out of the way if you get caught up in it. You can actually, I think you can jump it, or you can like outrun it. But anyway, just team up with your friends and try to take them down. You can't move the camera when you're in third person view, but if you go into first person view, you can actually move the camera like any first person shooter game. This would probably be the best way to play it. Did you see him stomp down? That was like the stomping attack. We almost got him. So we beat the boss. We collect our stuff and then we go back and then we sell what we got. As you keep playing, you will get to a point to where you can go to different parts of the map. I believe I opened the map up one time and I think I saw like 4 different areas. And if you look there, they're telling you which way you can go to get to different areas. And that antenna level, that's what I upgraded last, and it has to be that high before you're able to go. But this is a really good game, very much recommended. This game is Black Hawk Rescue Mission 5. And when you start, you go ahead and sign your agreement that if you cheat, then you cannot come back to the game unless you delete your account or something like that with Roblox. But go ahead and read through it. Try to play on a certain server, and then I tried some other servers, but I couldn't get in. So I just went on and did the free roam or the open world part of it. This area right here, I was just trying to test out some vehicles to see what I can get, and I was just gonna just roam out and see what I can find. And then I saw this guy in this helicopter. I was like, hey, let me go ahead and team up with this person and see what's going on. Unfortunately, when I started out, I didn't get the correct items for my loadout, so all I have is my gun, some bullets, and some bandages. Just looking at what the graphics look like, it looks very good for this Roblox game. Everything's clear, it's moving very smooth. The sounds are really great. The bullet shot sounds, guns going off, the backgrounds, the helicopter taking off, the sounds of the engine, all sound great. So this guy, he's like looking over the area trying to find some insurgents to take down. And we didn't find any, so we're gonna go ahead and take off. And he says, go to the desert. So that's where we're going to head. There's a guy down there. I guess he could be like chasing us. He wants to get on. So we go ahead and let him on. I actually shot that guy. I thought he was a bad guy, but I didn't show it. So we're heading out. We're going to land on top of this building. You know, there's a firefight going on, but I didn't see anybody, but the other guys did. So I'm going to go down and see what I can see down in this room, because there's a lot of rooms that could possibly need clearing out. I was just trying to take my time. Now, unfortunately, I didn't see anybody, but the sun was getting ready to go down. Looks like we have a full team here. And if you noticed, on their heads, they had night vision goggles. And guess what? I didn't have any. So I was sitting there, you know, in the dark. I couldn't see anything. This one is called Mad City. I'm pretty sure you've heard of it. And I'm just trying out some different costumes and see how they work. I like that one. I'm going to test out this outfit. And I kind of like failed. I thought I was going to like jump out and fly. But as you can see, I failed and flopped and rolled into the water. So once I got the hang of it, I found my first victim down here and I'm going to do some battle. I went home and changed costumes and got my favorite. I forget his name, but he throws fireballs. I like this guy. So I found another bad guy. I'm going to chase him down and try to take him out. And it took a very long time. It was a long battle with this guy. It went from like midday to sundown before I took him out. Too long to be taking a person down. Here I found a little partner that I was going to hang out with, so we were just flying around and going to try to find some crime to take care of. We finally found someone, and actually this isn't a bank, but actually a gun store. And we took him out, no problem. I guess 2 against 1, what do you expect? But this is a really good game, highly recommended. This game is called Q Clash, and it's like Overwatch. And it looks just like Overwatch, just about. I mean, it's Roblox, but it's Overwatch. Starting out, you'll have a roster that you can pick through. And some of them, again, they are offshoots of the original game. They all have special abilities that you can use. It takes a while to learn how to use them. And a controller is supported in the game. And turning is actually kind of slow. I didn't see any way that you can adjust the turning speed. But I thought we played pretty well. So if you can't afford the original Overwatch, then this will probably be the game that you could probably play. I mean, you know, there's some other free to play games out there, but if you want that Overwatch feeling, this is it. And especially when you can play on your cell phone. I mean, if you're the type of person that plays Roblox on the cell phone, then this will work. And we actually won. This is my favorite game right here, Bad Business. This is like Call of Duty Deathmatch with a little bit of parkour in it. And you're not going to be climbing any buildings, but the guy runs and it makes that sound where they climb up on something like really fast. In this match right here, we're playing like Gun Game. That's in Call of Duty, where you shoot a character and then you get another gun and then you keep going and until the end of the match. Really like this game. Very fluid. Again, if you can't afford Call of Duty, which you should be able to because Warzone is free, this will be the next best thing. And like I said, there's other games out there, but hey, no blood. You know, it's kid friendly if you wanted to, you know, if you got kids or something and you wanted to play it, want them to play it, and you're worried about blood, this is it. But there are guns in it, so you might consider that. Really enjoyed this game. It's one of my favorites now. There are loadouts that you can use. But I only stuck with the first one, which was an AK-47. I don't know if there's grenades. Yeah, there's grenades, which I didn't even use a grenade. And I just noticed it when I was doing this replay. So, basically Call of Duty. Played very smooth. We're getting around 200 FPS. This is on max quality. The GPU is not really getting used at all. CPU, barely. Look at that. 14%. So you can expect a whole lot more. This game is just like cruising on this machine. The there's barely any recoil when you're shooting, so when you shoot at something, you're usually gonna get it. Sound effects are great. Wow. It's a really good game. So if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And until the next time, Meme Poo out.